Dude, you are my best friend, man.
You're
my best friend. Dude, I want to suck your dick, man. You're my best friend, man. I'm sucking your dick. I'm joking, man. Maybe later, but dude, oh my god, you're a champ, man. You're a champ. Pound it, motherfucker. Oh, I exploded. I want to explode in your mouth. I'm just saying, you know what I mean?
I don't know what I'm saying.
Hey, look, I just got a text, honestly, just 5 minutes ago before I made these drinks for us. Got a text from my boy Jimmy. He wants us to go meet him. You want to go meet him?
I don't know who this Jimmy fella is.
Yo, remember Jimmy? We had geometry class together.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we had
he pulled my pants down in public.
Yeah, because you wanted to suck your dick. You got a big dick, motherfucker. You got a big ass dick. Big ass motherfucker dick.
That's why I haven't had a girlfriend in over 9,000 days.
That's what I'm saying. Now we gotta go put it to some motherfucker. He got some bitches, I think. We gonna call them the bitches because that's what they be. They be bitches. We gotta pay them to suck our dicks. You know, I'm not gonna suck your dick. I just said I would suck your dick, but I ain't gonna suck your dick. You ain't gonna suck my dick. I got bitches to suck my dick, and bitches gonna suck your dick. Come on, let's get in the road. Go meet up my friend Jimmy, and we're gonna suck some dick. I mean, we're gonna suck some bitches off.
Hey,
yeah,
some
dyke
little motherfucking
bitches.
Let's go fuck
them
up, bitches, motherfucker.
Oh, man. Oh, shit. Vehicle.
Yeah, I know, right?
Oh, shit. Oh! Dude. Oh, man. Driving. It was a good idea the first time. At first, it was a good idea. Oh, shit! Oh, man, dude. Oh, this shit's gonna be great. This shit's gonna be great when we get there. Man, Jimmy, he's gonna have to hook up for us. You ever smoke a little marijuana?
Oh, that guy smoked marijuana 7 years.
Yeah. Oh, 7 years? No, motherfucker. You gotta be smoking marijuana 7 times a motherfucking day. You gotta be 7 times a day, 7 days a week. 7 hours break for nothing. I don't give a fuck what I'm saying.
That's because you got too strung out even before
that's
you drank.
That's what I'm saying. Look, if you want to try some Coke,
You got any Coca-Cola?
Nah, some cocaine. He might have some cocaine.
Screw the cocaine, look, man. I want Coca-Cola.
His friend Keith always brings over some cocaine. You remember Keith?
Didn't he go to jail before?
Yeah, he went to jail. But, oh shit! Oh!
Whoa.
Fuck! Man, drunk! Holy shit! Oh, fuck. Damn it. Oh. No. Oh. Oh. What is this? No. No. No! Shit! Fuck!
What did you do?
Oh. The fuck? Damn it. Messing up, man. It does it all the time. Hey, look, this fucking place. Look. Oh shit, no, it's not in there. Take the gun. Look, follow me. Follow me. Look, grab my. Come on. Go fix this. Pop the hood. Ah, oh, there we go. Let me just do just a few more kinks to it.
He's dead. I'll send you the picture. We'll meet up, meet at the same place? Alright, I'll meet you there. I'm on my way. Okay. Alright.
Yeah, he's dead.
You gotta keep it down, man. There's too many people around here. I got some, but look, I got some, but let's go somewhere else and smoke. I don't want to smoke here. I feel crowded, you know. I feel paranoid smoking here with all these. You know, I'm safe.
You were back early.
Yeah, I knew the guy.
Well, that's great news to hear. Makes a job easier, I guess you would say.
30-year-old cigars. For victory. You can go ahead and have one, I guess.
Nah, I don't smoke.
You do now. Taste that. It's 30 years of age streaming down your throat.
Yeah, it tastes like shit.
Well, sometimes you just gotta deal with shit.
Anyways, I've got another job for you. Good job on that other one. There's a man that owes me a lot of money. I want that money. Goes by the name of Kringle. Chris Kringle.
Actually, while I was coming this way, I did a lot of soul searching, a lot of thinking. And like we talked about before, this last one, the one I just did, that was it. I'm giving this up. I'm giving this up. I'm becoming a writer. All right? It's my passion, it's my goal. That's what I'm going to do. I'm done with this. I'm tired of killing my friends, and...
Why don't you just shut the fuck up? You're done whenever I say you're done.
No. Fuck you. Fuck that. I'm done now. I ain't doing any more of your fucking dirty work, any more of your shit. I'm fucking done. I'm leaving. I'm done with this life. I'm done with this. I'm gonna put everything of my knowledge on the page. I'm gonna become a writer. I'm gonna write novels. Fuck you. Fuck you.
It's a lot of talk. A lot of talk you just did there, boy. You don't know what you're dealing with. You've never known. I picked you up off the streets when you were fucking nothing, and you still are nothing. You have obligations to fulfill. You can't just walk away, write your feelings down in a piece of paper. Fucking pathetic.
You're right. You did help me out. When I needed it the most. But like I said, I'm done with this. But I'll do this one last one. This one last one. For you, as a friend. What's the address?
Lives off North Lane. North Pole Lane. It's pretty simple to find.
Alright, how much money does he owe you?
What does it matter to you anyways? The money means nothing to you. But it's short, just short of $1 million.
Well, consider it my retirement.
You think you're the only person under my employ that can kill someone? Get him!
And everybody on the planet know you a star.
And the promoters, the beat that you got a char. You was a priest that gave the little ones tears. Pedophile, become cardinal in a year. Finally jailed him forever, you live in fear. The pussy riot play.
You insolent fool.
Pathetic fucking worm. Like I said, I'm done! I'll make sure to mention you in the epilogue! Fuck! Fuck!
You won't admit you love me, and so how am I?
If you can't make your mind up, I think I lost it. I don't have it, man. Like, where were we? Where did we come from? Where do we just come from? Like, I don't know where I could have lost it. We gotta. Oh, that last one we smoked. It was the last, it was our last one. Now we don't have a joint for walking with dinosaurs.
That was the last joint, you dumb fuck! Young boob, howly wolves. Ah! Bad thing to happen to you alone. Bad thing to happen to you alone. Bad thing to happen to you alone.
Wait.
Wait. I know a guy. His name's Papa Noel. He owes me money. He owes me like 40 bucks. We can go get it or just like go rob his ass. And then, no, we'll just go. No. He's not Santa Claus. He does sell some really dank Christmas tree weed. Anyway, yeah, we go and get the money and then we'll buy some weed for the movie. You know? Yeah. It's Stoner Adventure Time.
Yeah, it was fast, but you didn't have much money on it. Yeah, I could do one more time. What's the name? Yeah. One North Pole Lane. Alright, got it. I'll call you when I'm done.
God rest ye merry gentlemen, let nothing you dismay. Remember Christ our Savior was born on Christmas Day. Now to the Lord sing praises, all you within this place, and with true love and brotherhood each other now embrace. This holy tide of Christmas all other doth deface. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy.
Do you have a moment to talk about Jesus? What would you say if I told you that this book could set you free?
I would say that only the truth can set you free.
So, you're telling me that you'd rather sit here in your nefarious costume than believe in Jesus Christ Almighty God?
You believe in me?
You?
Santa Claus.
Hornswoggle, and how dare you make a comparison to Jesus Christ the Almighty? You should be punished for your blasphemous tongue.
So if you're bad, you should be punished.
Aye!
Well, coal sounds like punishment. Off of similar, if you ask me.
Many tricks of the devil to cloud and confuse the minds of young lads and lasses.
Society does that on their own. Surely the devil gives them a slight nudge in that direction. But ultimately, it's people that make their own decisions.
Oh, talk of the devil. And here I thought that you weren't a believer.
Oh, I never said that. You assumed that I didn't. Because you're what the common man calls a nut. I believe in God. The devil believes in God. And you can bet that I believe in the devil.
You make it sound as if you've met him personally.
Face to face.
I know. Life can be hard. And it feels like the devil is there with you, taunting you, singling you out. But the challenge is moving past your wrongdoings and getting past the hard times in life. What is it that you do?
I'm Santa.
What?
You know, Santa Claus. More in the mall, at the stores, on the sidewalk sometimes.
I see.
It's actually, I've been meaning to talk to a man of God.
Really now? About what?
Forgive me, Father, for I have sinned.
Seriously?
Oh, come on. It's surely why you came to my doorstep.
Fine. When was your last confession?
33 years ago.
What is your sin?
A child was sitting on my lap, and I got an erection. He asked what it was. I told him it was a blow pop. He wanted to ask if he can have it, and I told him no.
You wish to be forgiven for the erection?
No, Father. I want to be forgiven for not letting him have it.
Do you find this to be a joke, Boyle?
Kinda. And you're the punchline.
Mother Mary of God, you are riddled with corruption.
Well, Father, so is that book you're holding.
How can you believe in something, yet dispute the very word with which it is taught?
I believe in God, the Almighty, merciful, wrathful and loving. You type of people only preach his wrath, causes people to hate you. Not just you, but the one you speak of as well, the big man upstairs. People get mad when the only thing you preach is punishment and wrath. And the very same people tell you that he's loving, but they only believe in the loving part. It's a very parental relationship with God. It's like saying because my parents spanked me that they must be not be loving parents. Well, I believe in God, but I don't believe in this book. God did not write this book. Man did.
More copy?
Why not?
So, Reverend, did you notice the Christmas tree when you came in?
Well, yes, I did.
Is it real or fake?
How am I to know? I didn't feel like looking at the symbol of sin for too long.
You can't have Christmas without Christ.
Ugh, what a bunch of malarkey.
I'm just saying now, it's fake.
My wife always made me buy a real Christmas tree. Every goddamn year I had to clean up the fucking pine needles.
And one year, I bought a fake tree. And I sprayed some pine salt on that. Didn't notice a single difference. You kind of like that fake tree. You want to be a real tree. Just don't want to clean up your mess.
And what mess is it that you say that I have?
I'm saying you go door to door to preach to people. You probably have some secrets of your own. Not all it's cracked up to be.
Well, do you know what I think?
I think it's time you got to go. I got some more people coming over, and he doesn't particularly like Christians.
Is that him?
No. He doesn't knock.
Santa, open up! You better not be banging my wife!
What do you want?
People seeing you and my wife headed here. Are you banging my woman?
Maybe. What's the matter? Don't like to have a little Santa schluss to be asked to love you, old lady?
Are you slashing all over my Sally?
Maybe. You won't talk about it? We can talk with the good old Revan over here, saying kumbaya happy fucking holidays, and discuss whether or not she wrote on Santa's sleigh. But I'm expecting company, so try to be respectful.
Well, alright, I guess. And that's when Mama killed that sumbitch with her bare breast. That sumbitch should have never known to ask for the last dinner roll. Candy cane like that. Is my Sally here?
Yeah, your Sally came by. She wanted to get you a very special Christmas present. But, you know, of course, it comes with price, you know. You know, I came down that chimney all night long, Bubba.
You son of a bitch! I'm gonna kill you! You messing with my Sally!
Bernard! Help me!
Sally, is that you? You son of a bitch! I'm gonna kill you! Sally! What did they do to you?
Just so you know, Santa's candy cane reaches all the way to the floor. I love the smell of Christmas. It smells like babies. Reverend. Reverend. Time to wake up.
Oh, you willikers.
I love watching you sleep, but I prefer my company to be awake.
Where did Bernard go?
Something about diabetes.
Yes, quite abruptly.
Yeah, he had a sugar rush. Would you like some more coffee?
No, I think I'll pass. It's getting late and I must be going.
Take the fucking coffee.
What?
Sinners are coming. We all gonna need some prayer by the end of the night. There's one right now.
Come on in, Mason. Why don't you come sit in my lap and tell me what you want for Christmas?
Holy fucking Christ, this guy's got a gun.
What about your accent, Reverend?
Look, this is just a character that I do that helps with my job. What are you doing?
Someone who's been a very Nazi boy. Haven't you, Mason? Come on. Come on,
do you know me?
Well, I know you if you've been bad or good.
Then maybe you know I'm not someone to fuck around with. You owe Rodney Johnson a shit fuck ton of money, and you're gonna hand it to me. And then I'm gonna be on my merry way and let you get on with your gay little circle jerk costume party with your fucking boyfriend over here.
Hey, you're speaking in front of the Reverend right here, man. A man of God.
Sure don't want to sit in my lap.
Maybe we can all just sit down and talk about this, all right? There's no need for this, the violence or the guns. I don't know what's really going on here anymore.
Yeah, you see, tense, man. Sit down. Have a cup of coffee.
No, none of this bullshit. I'm here for the money. Give it to me now.
Here's your money. Now sit down before I use your guts as tinsel.
Big talk.
I'm not in a rush anyways.
How grand. So tell me, boy. What do you want for Christmas?
Money.
Well, at least he's an honest sinner. Ain't that right, Riff?
Boyle, money is the root of all evil.
Reverend.
Is that how you got into a life of crime?
No, it's just something I love doing. Well, loved doing. After this, I'm done. I'm gonna give all this up. Become a writer.
Breaking necks, burning down homes, the screams of women and children filling the air like a Christmas carol. To become a writer, I'm sure that'll last long.
No, after this I'm done. All I want to do is relax and put all my knowledge and experience on the page.
I'm personally glad you're changing your ways.
Oh my God.
Mason, maybe you can give me a lick.
The fuck was that? What? What am I fucking doing here? You guys are both... What about changing your ways, man?
Night's not over yet.
Bullshit!
Oh, Reverend. There are thieves. Criminals. We didn't do them a favor tonight.
Well, why did they come here?
This guy's boss isn't the only one I owe money to. I'm expecting at least one more person.
Did you just hear that? I think I heard a car.
Goody. More guests.
No, fuck that! I'm getting rid of this guy, and then I'm out of here.
Bring me back a present. I know how I love presents.
Mr. Nicholas, I have come for the money you owe Mr. Banks. You can bring it out now, or I will burn your home down. The choice is yours. Make it quick.
Malachi, it's been a long time.
Mason, I don't want any trouble with you. This is mine.
You're a good rival, but if you get in my way, I'll be forced to kill you.
I was here first. This is my last gig and I'm seeing it through to the end. You have been a good rival. You say you have to kill me. If I step in your way, well, I'm stepping in your way. Might as well end this rivalry on a high note.
You're a dumb son of a bitch. You're good. But you're not better than I am.
Let's put that to the test then, shall we?
Let's.
So, Reverend, what do you want for Christmas?
I've never wanted a gift for Christmas, ever. It's a ludicrous holiday.
Oh, don't lie.
Not lying!
Come on, you're talking to the father of all lies. You must have wanted something one time. Maybe when you was a little reverend?
I wanted a red wagon when I was, you know, one of the radio flyers. Everybody always told me if you were good and you wrote Santa a letter and sent it to the North Pole, you'd get your gift. But I did, you know. I was exemplary kid, you know. I did everything they told me to do. It never came true, and that's when I knew this holiday was a fake. This was just a sick lie that they feed to children, and they induce these children with these thoughts by Satan. It's too much.
You say you wanted a wagon, but what you really wanted was steak knives to carve the old man into little Prancer snacks. Poor Prancer. He ate so much of them, he just weighed a little bit too much. Had to put him down.
How do you know this?
I told you, I'm Santa Claus. How'd you like it when your father touched you? Because I personally loved every minute of it.
You can't be the Santa.
You worried why I know you're actually here? I like the getup. It's different. But a reverend, that's pretty low, man.
What's happening?
Maybe it's something you drank. Or it might be the Christmas spirit. I'll get the missile to
You should have just walked away. You said this was your last gig. Now, do you have any last words before I kill you?
Yeah. Merry fucking Christmas!
You fucking dumbass!
Santa Claus!
Hello, Mason. Tonight the chair.
Well, I'm just gonna go.
Oh, but Christmas isn't over yet, Mason.
Yeah, no, I think I'm gonna go.
You can't be.
Yeah, well, fuck you.
Hell, Santa!
Ho, ho, ho! Let me go! I don't want to be the guy that killed Santa Claus!
It's you or me, Mason. Quick with the foreplay if you're gonna stick me. Stick me!
I thought you would be more jolly!
And I was gonna stuff your stocking.
Oh!
Hey, boss. Yeah, I got the money.
But what?
Keep the money? Wow, thanks. Thank you so much. Yeah, my daughter's really been needing that operation. Oh my gosh, thank you so much. Yeah, happy Hanukkah. Alright, thank you so much. You have no idea what this means to me. Alright, thank you so much. Bye.
Motherfucker! You give me the goddamn money right the fuck now! I mean, what the fuck?
No!
real girl, bitch! You better give me that motherfucking money! You're gonna get it to me right the fuck now!
God, I hate the holidays.
Have a holly jolly Christmas. It's the best time of the year. I don't know if there'll be snow, but have a cup of cheer. Have a holly jolly Christmas. And when you walk down the street, say hello to friends you know.
Dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh. Over the fields we go, laughing all the way. Bells on bobtails ring, making spirits bright. What fun it is to ride and sing a sleighing song tonight.
Good night, everybody. Hope you enjoyed the film. Hope you learned something from it. We are not too jealous just because you're at home and no money, just like the guys in the movie. At least you can get up and get some water. You know, those guys, they can't move. Hope you understand. They all. I don't know where they went. I don't plan on following them. And that's all I have to say. Merry Christmas. I have to go. Hope you enjoy the film. And, don't feel too bad if you're jealous. Go now. Goodbye. The guys that shot each other, they can't move. And be happy you can, if you're bored at home and you got nowhere to go, at least you can walk around your yard. I don't know where those guys went and all that. They can't move, and hope you're not jealous like they are, because you don't have any money. Well, look at the bright side. Sometimes I don't have any money. There's a lot to enjoy just because I don't have money. Sometimes I don't like to have money. I hope you enjoy the holiday.